What's up, everyone? It's Sammy D here. This is Kart Life. Thanks so much for tuning in. All things Mario Kart and Mario Kart Tour here. If it's your first time, please give a subscribe, please give a like, and send this to a Mario Kart friend if you like what you see. We're inching towards 1,000 subscribers, which is a big benchmark for this channel. I started just for fun just a couple months ago. Thanks so much. Today we're gonna look at the Ranked Cup for Baby Daisy Cup and the Flower Tour. Talk about some strategies, some tips, some lines through each track, show some quick playthroughs of each track. Hopefully it helps you out in your ranked. Hope everyone's getting those extra 100 coins from the multiplayer loading screens. It's on top of your coin limit break every day, so you can get up to about 500 coins a day now. The 300 plus the limit breaking over that plus 100 from multiplayer. It's a little tedious. You can go in and out as you wait for a multiplayer race to load. Hope you don't get an error that resets everything, but it should work. You just have to kind of tediously keep reloading it. I do it while I make my morning coffee and check my Animal Crossing trees for items. So extra 100 coins for free on the table for you. And of course, we're waiting for the Jungle Tour starting next Tuesday late night. The preview image only shows this Dino Jungle image, and looks like we're not getting DK Jungle or a new track. It's kind of to be expected. We have to keep our expectations very low always. And there's a major Funky Kong contingent out there, I realize, and Dixie Kong. I'm, again, not getting my hopes up for that. But you know what? They surprised us with Monty Mall last time. We could also get a new character like Petey Piranha. We'll have to see, but my expectations are low. I'm expecting just like a DK reskin. The main question I have is if the new update features will start in the Jungle Tour. I'm talking player level beyond 99. I'm talking expert challenges, the Coins Aplenty event. If any of this stuff rolls out in this coming Jungle Tour, I'll be fine with no new track or character. I just want to see these updates come into the game. So stay tuned. Wednesday morning, I'll post my reaction video to the new tour. So stay tuned for that. But today we're talking about Ranked Cup and going to go through each track, and I'll explain where I'm at and hopefully speak to each of y'all. If you're new players to the game, leave a comment below. I'd love to get a survey of where everyone's at. I know there's a lot of newer players who started playing maybe after the New Year's tour. So I want to speak to those players when I talk about these strategies, but also people like me who've been playing since day one and tell you what my setups are and the successes I've had or lack thereof. Last week, I actually tiered down to 39 for the first time. I was placed just in a really hard group, right? So I had all these players in tier 40. And this is the problem with keeping it at tier 40. If they were to expand beyond tier 40, then all these whale type players and people who have just spent some money on the game or have everything up to level 6, they would move up to the higher tiers. Right now, everyone's crammed into tier 40, right? If you've done the most you can with this game, we're all in tier 40 or tier 38, 39. And the upper 30s and tier 40s are getting really crammed. So it might happen that you just happen to get paired up with someone who's way higher than you. And it really should be matched more by skill level. And if we had more tiers, we could subdivide in a little bit more of a balanced way. So I did get placed against people I just couldn't beat, and I did tier down to 39. The good news was I knew that even using my high-end tickets, I wouldn't be able to win ranked. So I was able to save my ranked tickets, and now I'm in tier 39, and it is much easier. Let's take a look at my situation here. So I'm in first, I got 55, and my competitors are not close yet. It's still a few days. And by the way, the reason I like to do these on the weekends for y'all is I have a strategy for ranked that I think you should consider. It's really that you need to wait a few days, at least until Saturday, Sunday, sometimes Monday, Tuesday when some sleepers come in. You need to first of all see how well you can do, what your ceilings are, before you use any tickets. Don't go using tickets right away on the players that are top shelf. You might win ranked without using the ticket. So first see how good you can do. Then you have to see what all your competitors are gonna do. And in the new update, it makes it really nice to look at your competitors now and see the actual levels and see any frenzies they've gotten. Now, it shows top shelf and frenzy on any new runs since the update from this week. So some of them don't show that. But nonetheless, you can see the levels, you can see what you're competing against, and kind of anticipate, okay, what's this player gonna be able to get? And so that's why I like to wait till the weekend before you make any big moves, before you even grind that much. Do some runs to see how well you can do. Then you can decide, do I really need to use my tickets? Am I going to have to use my tickets? Do I want to buy more things in the shop? Or do I want to just wait and save my coins because I don't need to buy those things? I don't need to use those tickets. And now I'm in a situation in tier 39. Granted, only got 10 rubies last week from ranking down into tier 39, but now I'm only competing for 35, so it's a net loss of rubies in these two tours. However, I'm able to know that I'm probably gonna win first. I don't even have to use any of my high-end tickets for Vacation Peach for high-end carts. I'm in Chaco not even using a level 2 cart, so the Apple cart, which was Gold Pass. I haven't even had to upgrade it for bonus point boost. And typically I would be like, oh, let's upgrade immediately so I can get the bonus point boost. You might not even need to do that. And so I'm sitting on some tickets and going into Jungle Tour when I'm gonna be back in tier 40, I'll actually have some tickets to work with. Two high-end drivers, and Gold Koopa, by the way, is in one or maybe two of the Dino tracks. So you wanna think about what drivers, carts, and gliders are gonna be in tracks like Dino Jungle, RT. One of these will be in ranked next week. So I know I can use some of these tickets next week. So that's how I like to look at ranked. It's really a long game strategy of only using a ticket when you absolutely have to, and only buying things in the shop when you have to as well. So let's talk about each track and the strategies and some tips for each. I had an easy time with this ranked in tier 39, but there are some really hard aspects to at least two of these tracks, Toad Circuit R and Mario Circuit R. These are not trick tracks. So unlike Chaco, which is kind of gonna hold your hand through the race, very easy nonstop combo situation with all these ramps and jump boosts. But for Toad Circuit and Mario Circuit, there are some stretches, some dead zones where you really try to figure out how to connect your combo. And getting a nonstop combo, especially one to record for y'all and show you as an example, was really hard. But hopefully you'll pick up a couple tips. Let's go to Toad Circuit R first. Off the bat, Vacation Peach is top shelf for two of the tracks, Toad Circuit and Mario Circuit R. So if you have her, got her in the Valentine's Tour or back on the Paris Tour, you're really in luck and you wanna think about a high-end ticket if you're gonna need a boost on these levels in ranked, because the coin box is so good for chaining combos and dead zones. But let's say you don't have her. The options for you are Diddy Kong. I know everyone hates the banana barrel at first, but if you are very smart and very careful, take use of the steering button and do some really subtle, really masterful driving. You can very easily use the banana barrel to take out all your opponents and dodge your own bananas. It's possible. You're up to the challenge. I know you are. Then we have Baby Daisy. Now, this is very controversial because a lot of people have her higher than anyone else. For example, I have her at level 5, which if you hold down, always check these stats, it's a 4x bonus point boost. So that's really good for your overall bonus point boost. But the bubble. If you have a bubble in a slot, you're gonna lose an item. It's not gonna spawn a new item in a slot. The bubble's gonna take it. You can't pop the bubble. You can't gain additional points while you're in the bubble. The bubble frenzy is pretty good, I will admit, because you get a hit for every time you tap the screen on the bubble. But honestly, the bubble is more trouble than it's worth. You'll see, as I did, that even a 4x bonus point boost with the bubble is problematic because you miss certain items. You miss chances at frenzies, because if you can't get all three items when you pass over an item, you're not gonna have a frenzy chance, and the bubble really blows that. So I would go Diddy, or if you have Vacation Peach, obviously Vacation Peach, okay? For carts, we have some good options. The taxi I got in the first New York tour, I actually have it at level 4, because I think I used my high-end tickets on it in the first tour. And then we have the Zucchini, it's pipe locked. We have the B Dasher, which is in the daily selects if you're lucky enough to find it. Hopefully everyone's found at least one of those by now, or pulled it. It is in the high-end cart allotment. Then you have the Queen Bee, okay? A little more rare than the Bumble V, which we got as a gift, but this is dash panel. There are some dash panels in that last stretch. So dash panel is great if you got the Queen Bee and you got it leveled up, especially. That could be really good for that last stretch of dash panels. And then what's the last one here? I don't have this one yet, Circuit Special. Yeah, I think this is still in the pipe. Yeah, it's funny, it's the only high-end cart I don't have, I think, from the pipe. So still waiting on getting that one. For me, it's really about just what is leveled up highest. In my case, the taxi, it has jump boost, which is not a good skill for Toad Circuit R. There are no jumps on this, except that one little shortcut. So really, it's not gonna give me much bonus point, but the overall multiplier on overall bonus points. So when you get coins, when you get frenzies, you're gonna get little bonus point boosts added to the grand total. And I got 3x bonus points. So I'm going with the taxi, but you might do the Zucchini or the Bee Dasher, whatever you have leveled up highest. For glider, I always talk about leveling up those super gliders that are in the shop, like the Bomb Glider. And here, once again, it's paying off so much. Level 6 Bomb Glider. Now it's funny, even with a full Bomb Glider at 20% combo time, there are times when your combo drops on this track. It's very frustrating and weird to try to figure out, but that's a great option. And then the Piston Glider is pipe locked, but if you've done a lot of pulls, you've probably got it at some point by now. Then we have two kind of more rare spotlight gliders, the Butterfly Sunset, which is in a bundle right now and in the high-end glider allotment in the pipe. And then we have the Rainy Balloons, which I still don't have. It's a pretty good glider, got some good top shelf levels. So I'm going with Bomb Glider, and let's take a look at the run, show you a couple things. Okay, I might pause it a couple times here to point out a couple things. The opening rocket start should get you pretty far to right about here. And then you want to release a turbo. It'll get you really far. You want a turbo to those two coins on the inside line. And then this first little stretch into the next coin strip is a very packed, dense area with lots going on. Everyone's getting items, so it's going to be kind of a cluster. You're going to try to survive. Let's see what happens here. Coin, they will get in your way. A coin box, look at that, beautifully connects me all the way to the next line of coins, which starts here. But if you don't get a coin box, you can boost to the right and then boost back to the left. Don't worry, you can get it with normal turbos. Here you want to release, grab an item, and immediately do another boost, and then try to sneak one more in here. Now, this stretch right here, as you know, we have some fun things to work with. I like this part because it is a dead zone, but you have the fun challenge of shooting a Goomba with a green shell. If you've got one, that will work. Boosting into a Goomba, which will slow you down for a second. But the cones right after the Goombas are also combo earners. So the more you kick those cones, as you know, it's a really fun way to get combos. I just love it's a very satisfying feeling to kick the cones. So hopefully between a boost, a shell, a mushroom, whatever you have, you make it through this section in a fun way. You can boost around them, go for cones here, and then start this dash panel stretch. It's very easy. I like to release turbos in between them as much as you can, just to add to the multiplier for your total actions. You want to drift into those last three coins pretty easy, and then that should boost you to the finish line, but I would say around the finish line is a great item ticket slot. This is a little bit of, as you can see, a long stretch, and first place will get you far to the next boost, but it is a good place to use your ticket right here. Let's see what happens next. Another coin box, very helpful. Once again, I can set up a nice long boost. Pink. That'll get me all the way there without having to do anything. Look at that. So nice. Release a boost here. You want to do two boosts, one, and then one more. Or if you spawn coins, you maybe can hold that and try to get that orange boost to get you further through that section. Somehow narrowly dodged a red shell there, and then we're onto the dash section. And once again, it's pretty easy from here. Coast is clear, smooth sailing. You can boost again to these three coins. Coin box, in this case, carried me all the way to the finish line. You can see how nice that coin box is. And that's with no frenzies, no item ticket, and it's a nonstop combo at 17,000. So took me a while to get that run, and you know the AI can be a little aggressive. Not as aggressive as Mario Circuit R, which we'll get to in a second, but that's Toad Circuit R for you. Okay, Remix Choco Island 1T. This is a fun track. It's a version of Choco Island 1, which has not come to the game yet from SNES, but they built off the original Choco Island 1 and built this new remix course. It's a brand new course. I mean, the cool thing about the remix courses, they're reusing the assets they already have, but they're basically creating a brand new course that is completely unfamiliar to us. So it's essentially a brand new course. I really love the remix courses, especially the trick versions. They're just combo city. So let's go in and take a look at the loadouts. This is a nice situation because you got two daily select drivers available, Daisy and Yoshi. You're going to have one of them higher than the other. I would go with whatever one is the highest for you. Also, if you have super driver tickets, these yellow tickets to upgrade, I've got five, but I'm trying to save those for characters like Wario or Rosalina, Waluigi, people who are not in the daily selects, because you can buy one of these upgrades for 3,000 coins if you got it. So go with whoever you have highest, but I will say Heart is very nice. The Heart actually protects you from lightning. It's amazing. You know, in these runs, when you're having a great run and all of a sudden you get struck by lightning, having a heart completely solves that problem. Now, the Yoshi egg is nice too. It's great for frenzies, throwing them forward and hitting a bunch of people or behind you. So either of these are really good. I have Daisy at 3, and since she has the hearts and it's a little more defense and protection from things like lightning, I'm going with Daisy. Monty Mole, still don't have him. I'm not pulling. I'm gonna bank on him being in the pipe going forward. And Monty will come to me whenever he's ready. Holidaisy is also in here. Lucky 7 is really good. So obviously it's going to be a top scorer if you have her leveled up. I'm going with Daisy. And on the carts, it's a little limited, but Gold Pass does get the Apple cart. If you're not Gold Pass, you're really up a creek here, because the Green Apple Cart is in the bundle and in the pipe high-ends right now. And then the Prancer was last week's spotlight. So it's still in that pipe. If you did pull it, or if you're going to pull it, I don't recommend these 100 pipes. They're not great. Although the Monte Mole pipe does have one extra high-end driver. Keep that in mind. But Gold Pass really comes to help right here, and you have the Apple Cart. Now, if you don't have any of the top shelf and you're newer to the game and you don't have Gold Pass free to play, you want to go to the second tier. And this is a little tough too. It's a lot of spotlights, as you can see. There's nothing that's just in the shop. So you might be all the way down at the bottom. And in that case, anything with Jump Boost Plus. There's so many jumps. Focus on a Jump Boost Plus car. That'll do the trick. So again, I didn't even upgrade this one to level 2 yet, and I was still able to get a really nice score. And the gliders, it's also a little tricky. Once again, we have this pink gold paper glider, which again, bundle and pipe locked right now. We have the heart balloons, which have proven to be a really useful glider from Valentine's or whenever it was. Look at this, this is insane. 13 top tracks, and only two of them are city tracks. So without the cities, it's 11 top tracks. So I put my high-end ticket to this one, I think like last week. Heart balloons are great, and they are the spotlight right now in the Monte Mole pipe. Another nice reason to consider pulling on the Monte Mole pipe. If you're gonna do some pulls anyway, if you need to stock up your inventory these days, it's a nice one to do because you got two high-end drivers and the heart balloons, not to mention Monte Mole. So very nice. Okay, sound is off for this one because I was listening to a podcast. You don't want to hear that. So again, this one's pretty easy. It does hold your hand as you go through. It's very easy and nonstop combo. You're basically going to follow the course, set up your drifts way early so that you can be prepared for each turn. Daisy seems to spawn coin frenzies a lot. I don't know why some characters spawn certain frenzies more than others. It might just be psychological in my head. But it seems that way. Like, I never got a coin frenzy with Toad on Mario Circuit at all in 50 tries. Yet, Daisy, I get coin frenzies in first a lot. Now, again, you're just following the track here. The AI will cut in front of you on mud sections, or if you take turns too wide to go for coins. Keep that in mind. They're passing me right now. A little bit sloppy here, but, you know, you can easily get a full combo, like, on one lap right there. With not much trickery. So here we go, coming around the next lap, and a couple things I wanna point out. Again, the heart is gonna be great protection. Those four coins are gonna help you, but people will pass you. So front running for coins is a little tough on this one. By the way, there's a little sneaky thing here. See that little line to the side of the mud? You can actually power slide right through that, a la Excite Bike Arena in Mario Kart 8. It's a little trick. It'll work. Or you can just cut through the mud like everyone else does. But I like to boost here into one and two coins. Well, one got taken away, but you get the idea. There's two coins there for you. There's actually three. So however you do that turn, you can grab one or two coins. Now on this long turn, everyone's taking really the tight inside line. You can see them there ahead of you. And if you're going to want to go for that right dash panel coming up on the very end of the curve, just make sure you stay in the center of the ramp. You don't need to go super wide. Keep things as tight as you can because you do want to end up in first place, and it's a kind of short track. So keep that in mind. And there's a little strat for this ramp I'm going to show you in a second. But for now, I like to hold my drift, hold it, and then we're off that ramp. And this is a great cut for mushrooms, as you can see. Let's see that one more time. You can see how much you can cut off with a couple of mushrooms or a mushroom frenzy or any frenzy. Boom, boom. One mushroom will get you through it with a little bit of a lag at the end of the mud. Let's look at this. I want to show you a little strat you can do. It's a common thing in Mario Kart Tour now, are finding with the combos, that if there's a ramp that has a line of coins on it, you can do a hard, I'll call it a hammer, not to be confused with the hammer item, but you can kind of hammer into the left, do a hard power slide 90 degrees and get as many of those coins as possible. The invisible wall at the end will redirect you back on the track. This is a little sloppy, but you'll see what I mean. Check it out. I got at least a couple coins there, I think. And then it automatically sends you back on the track and your combo does continue. So once again, as you're coming into the coins, set it up like this and then kind of aim to the left. Again, I didn't do a great job here. I probably only got one coin because someone stole one, but yeah, I just got one. But anyway, you see the idea. If you hammer all the way to the left, you can get three or four of those. That first came up in Neo Bowser City. And I think Daisy Hills, you can pull that off as well. Certain tracks, Bowser's Castle. So keep that in mind. But again, you need to be in a good lead, right? You will sacrifice a position point or two when you do that. Keep that in mind for combo time. Okay, lastly, Mario Circuit R, and this is just, this was brutal, man. The AI seems really jacked up on here. If there's an argument that the AI is harder or more aggressive on certain tracks, this one proves it to me. I don't know if you've had the same experience, but it's really hard to get a run through this without getting hit by lightning multiple times, you know, all kinds of crazy computer behavior. So here's what we have, Toad in the Daily Selects. So if you don't have Vacation Peach, who's here once again, very nice. You want to go for Toad. Rosalina's in the pipe locked. Then we have two spotlights, Party Time Toad and Daisy Fairy. I really want Daisy Fairy. I'm really hoping that when she comes back in another pipe, I can finally get her. Not pulling for her now though, but she's a great design. Toad is probably your guy because three mushrooms, triple mushrooms, really nice frenzy. It's kind of the same as a mushroom frenzy, I think, although you go a little faster with a triple mushroom. But yeah, it's a really good one to have here. So if Toad's in your shop, think about buying him. And if you have to throw a ticket on him, you can, but try to save those tickets if you can. And actually, my Toad's higher level than Vacation Peach. So even though Vacation Peach is a high end with Coin Box, and the Coin Box frenzies are really nice, my level 4 Toad is going to be better on a base level because he's got 3 times bonus point boost and 5% chance of frenzies. So if I'm front running with either of these two, I do have a better chance of coin frenzies with Toad. Vacation Peach has just got 4% and times 2. So let's go to the cart. Royale has been a Gold Pass gift. The P-Wing is a pipe locked high end. The Kabuki Dasher is a former spotlight. And then we have this bundle locked Rose Queen. And then the last bundle locked Wild Wing, which I don't think is available at all anymore. A little tough, but hopefully you have the Royale from Gold Pass at least. A mini turbo car or a jump boost car would be really nice, but I happen to, again, this is my starting line. I have just level 1 and level 2, and I could upgrade any of these things. I could upgrade this, I could put high-end tickets toward P-Wing, take it, let's see, I got 3 tickets, so I could take it to level 2 and then level 3 as well if I wanted to. But I wanted to see how well I can do. Turns out I don't even need to do that this ranked. I'm really glad I didn't impulsively pull those tickets on these cards. I can save them for the future. On the gliders, the oil paper umbrella happens to be level 4 for me. I think it was ranked previously and I used some tickets on it at that time. This is an example of a great glider or a super to use your tickets on because it's not in the shop. And when it does come up in ranked, you're gonna wish it was a higher level. But you also have the 2020 glider. Some people may have put a high-end ticket onto that one and it's got mushroom, which is nice. Or the Peach Hanafuda, Mega Mushroom. Also the Daisy glider, if you happen to pull for that. So that's my glider situation. And at level 4, my oil paper umbrella, the run you're gonna see is a 15% combo time. So let's just, this run is going to be ridiculous, but really it did take me like 50 tries to even get a recordable run. So much stuff happens. It's really tough. This is one of the most deceptively hard ranked cup tracks we've ever had, I will say. And I wouldn't be surprised if y'all are struggling. I feel your pain. So the rocket start is going to get you to the first jump and coin. Go ahead and start your drift, because you're gonna wanna get this item, hold it, and then release it right about there. If you wait much longer than, I released early just to be safe, but it will die right around there. So just be careful if you wanna go and start off strong with a combo chain. Now, this stretch really hard. You just have to hope you have some items that get you through. If you got a green shell, you might go for that Goomba. If you got a mushroom, you might go for that ramp. If you got nothing, you're just gonna wanna try to turbo your way through. I go here, I go one more, and then bang out to the left. Yes, it works. You can turbo your way through. These three coins, it's really hard to go on this ramp without just riding that left rail. But if you got peels or shells, just throw them behind you. Throw them behind you because they'll probably hit. But do release a boost right around here so that you can get those coins that are ahead of you and set up to go to the left. Let me show you what I do in this stretch. I do not go straight through this curvy path. I boost here to the coin ramp. Go to the right, get this coin ramp, go all the way to the right, hammer out one more turbo. That to me is the Japanese style strat I think you have to employ, because even with 15%, if you just go straight through that curved path to get those coins, they're there for you. It looks like it will work, but you won't make it to that dash panel. So here, here, and then one more to the left. and that should keep you going. Now, here's another scary part. Keeping combo through this stretch, you're gonna wanna boost to one of these coins and use your items, another item line really fast, but combo can easily die in this section. So just good luck. That's all I know how to say. I can't believe I survived that. Dropping items, going for these four coins, and here is your item ticket spot. I know there's a lot coming real fast here, but go for these coins, and then I would go ahead and use your item to set you up for this stretch, because it's a long stretch to those next coins. Go and use your item ticket here, and you might get really lucky like me and get them frenzy. If so, that's the best case scenario. You're gonna keep a run at the end of the day where you have a frenzy or two. So you wanna try to go for runs like this. Again, release that boost. I happen to get a pink one, so that's nice. Fight your way through here. Let's see what I have. What I do this time. A red shell gets me through, and I get to pick up their coins. And then a regular boost will get me to the inside of the castle. Again, hard to not just ride that rail. Another frenzy came through for me big time here. And now I didn't do the ramps while I had this frenzy. I went straight because at this point I'm trying to procure first place. I had to get that super horn hit on Peach. Finally got her. Boost here to a coin. Get rid of these items real fast because another item's coming at you. I think I dropped combo. Yeah, I dropped combo, but dodge the blue shell. At this point, I'm like just giving up. I'm just giving up because I dropped combo. And that's fine to drop combo. You might not get a perfect combo on this track. Don't be hard on yourself if you can't pull it off. Do the best you can. You might break it once or twice, but just try to get first. Try to get a frenzy run, and that might be your ceiling. You find out for yourself what you can do. Bonus secret here. I have not heard anyone talk about this just yet. It's about landing inside the castle. Now check this out. Keeping combo right. Boom. Jump boost trick off the entrance to the castle. If you aim so you are almost about to hit the wall and fall down and miss the landing, if you get right on there, you will get a trick, a jump boost for 108 points. It just happened accidentally, and now I try to go for it. So it's pretty nice. It's pretty nice. Hopefully you can pull off that little secret. Little Easter egg for you. So that's Ranked Cup Breakdown. Thanks for sticking in for this long video. Look forward to Jungle Tour. Let me know how you do below. Thanks to everyone in the comments for leaving their own tips on Ranked. That's always helpful to get everyone further along in Ranked. Thanks for all your comments. Thanks for the subscriptions. Send us to a Mario Kart friend. Stay home, stay safe, and we'll see you next week for the Jungle Tour. Take care, everyone.